Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install WAMP Server in a Windows 11 operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before starting, I would like to introduce the sponsor for this video, Cloudways. Cloudways allows you to avoid web hosting hassles so that you can totally focus only on your business. Using their innovative platform, you can go live in minutes. All you need to do is you need to first simply select your application and then your server. And after that, you need to just simply select your server size and you are ready to go. Please use the affiliate link in the description to support Geeky Script channel and also use our unique promo code Geeky to avail 20% discount for 2 months. Now to install WAMP Server, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, you need to just simply type WAMP Server download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.wampserver.com is basically our first search result. So just simply click on our first link and it will going to redirect you to this official site of WAMP Server. Right here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this downloads options, right? So here you can use WAMP Server for 64-bit or 32-bit. So since this is a 64-bit operating system, so what we are going to do is we are going to just simply click on this download button and it will going to open this window. Here you can see that they have given this form. So what we are going to do is we are going to just simply click on this. You can download it directly. So just simply click on that so that our download can start automatically. We don't need to fill any form and all. And it will going to redirect you to this SourceForge official site. Right, so here you'll be getting this download the latest version button. So just simply click on that to start downloading our WAMP server. And it will going to start downloading our WAMP server after 5 seconds. And you can see it has rightly started downloading. Right, so since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see the WAMP server 3.2.6 has been rightly downloaded over here. So this is the installation file that we are going to install on our Windows 11 operating system. So to install, you need to just simply double click on it and it will going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you can see that our WAMP setup installation wizard has been directly opened over here and it is currently asking to select a language. So let us first minimize our download directory and if I simply click on this drop down of language, you can see that it has given 2 languages. I'm going to choose English and then just simply click on OK. And this is the license agreement. Right, so if you have time, you can always read that. I'm going to simply accept this agreement and then just simply click on next. And then it is showing some installation information and all, so you can read that also. If you have time, I'm going to show you all steps. So just simply going to click on next and you can totally relax, right? I'm going to show you each and every step on this video only. And you can see that it is going to create this WAMP 64 folder, so keep this as a default. Otherwise, if you want to change, you can always do that by just simply clicking on this browse button, right? And then just simply click on next. Now under these select components, they have selected some files. You can see that they have selected so many files. So our latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.1, they're going to be used. Right, so keep this as all default and then just simply click on next. And you can see that they're going to create this WAMP server 64 folder. Right, so keep this as default, then again simply click on next. And it is ready to be installed, so just simply click on install to basically start our installing WAMP server. So this will take a couple of minutes, so what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our WAMP server. Yeah. So welcome back, and now as you can see that our WAMP server has been rightly installed, so just simply click on next. And you can see that it has rightly installed our 3.2.6 version, right? And then just simply click on finish. So now that our WAMP server has directly installed, you can see that our desktop shortcut icon is also created over here, WAMP Server 64. So just simply double click on it, and it will again ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. If it throws some error, then just simply click on OK. And then if you just simply click on this arrow, you can see that our WAMP server is properly running and it's green, right? So this WAMP server is actually under this hidden icon, so you can always drag it to make it outside, and you can see that our WAMP server is right in our taskbar. So now that our WAMP server is properly running and it is green, so if you just simply go to your favorite browser, just open a new tab, and here in the address bar, if you just simply type localhost, then enter, you can see that our WAMP server rightly opened in our browser. So this WAMP server you are able to see because it is turned green. So if it's yellow or red, then you'll not able to see this page. So for that, you need to install this WAMP server properly, right? Only after successfully install this software, after you just ran it, it will going to turn green, and then only you'll be able to see this page. So our server is running properly on our local system. Now I'll show you how to run PHP program. So for that, you need to first simply go to your C drive, and then you'll be seeing this WAMP Server 64 folder has been actually created over here. So just simply double click on it to go inside that folder, and here you'll be getting this www folder. This is very important. To communicate with your server, we use this www folder. Right, so just simply go inside that folder, and here if you just simply right click on it, and then if you just simply click on new folder, and here let's create a new folder as PHP workspace. And now if you just simply go inside that folder and again simply click on new text document, just simply open this text document, and here if you just simply type, I'm going to first make our font a big so that you can watch properly. And here if I just simply echo hello world, right, then just going to save it as prog.php. this is very important, you need to save it as a .php extension and make it as all file type. So if you just simply do that, and if I just minimize it, you can see that our prog.php has been actually saved over here, right? So now just go a directory back, and here if you just simply right click on it, then click on show more options, then rename. So here you need to just simply copy this file path, basically the folder path, right? And now again, if you just simply go to your browser, and after localhost, all you need to do is you need to just simply give a slash and then right click on it and paste, right? So localhost slash php underscore workspace, the name of your directory. And here you can see that our directory's contents inside this directory has been rightly shown. So you have created this prog.php right over there. So now if you just simply click on that file, you can see hello world has been rightly shown in our console. So all this basically mean is our WAMP server is properly installed and it is properly running, right? So here if you just simply change it this hello world to hello everyone, and if you just simply save it, and if you just simply go to your browser and reload it, you can see hello everyone rightly shown in our browser, right? So in this way, you can easily install WAMP server on your Windows 11 operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.